Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install Microsoft SQL Server on your Windows operating system. So let's begin. Now to install Microsoft SQL Server, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and in that this bar just simply type Microsoft SQL Server download, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this www.microsoft.com, then SQL Server download is basically our first search result. So just simply click on SQL Server downloads and it will going to redirect you to this official site of Microsoft, and here you can see try SQL Server on premises or in cloud. So I'm going to, you know, just simply scroll down and here you can see that it is available for developer mode and express mode. So I'm going to recommend you to download the express mode because it is ideal for development as well as production for desktop. So I'll be just simply click on download now and it will going to start downloading our SQL Server. So it has rightly downloaded. So let us first minimize it, and if I go to my download directory you can see our SQL Server is rightly over here. So you need to just simply double click on it. And it will going to ask you for administrative privileges, so for that just simply click on yes and you'll be seeing our SQL Server 2019 has rightly opened over here. So from here you need to choose the type of installation. I'm going to choose basic and you'll be seeing our license terms and agreement has rightly opened. Before installing I'll just simply minimize my download directory, and here I'll just, you know, simply accept this license agreement. And this is going to be our installation destinations, so you can, you know, just simply change it by just simply clicking on browse, but I'll be keeping this as a default. And you can see that it is going to download about 266 MB of files to, you know, install our Microsoft SQL Server. So you need to have an active internet connection. So what we have downloaded this is basically just an installer. So now the real installation or real download will actually happen. So keep this default, just simply click on install, and what it will do is it will going to first download and then it will going to install. So for that you need to have active internet connection, right? So this will, you know, take a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back right after finishing of this process. Yeah, okay, so welcome back, and you can see that it has successfully installed, but it actually took about 15 minutes I would say. So don't know why it took that much time, but it took. Okay, so I just wanted to mention that. And you can see that here we have a connection string, and then we have this log folder, then media folder, and finally we have this resources folder. So you can keep this all default. You can test your installation by just, you know, simply clicking on this connect now. And if you see this type of pop-up, then all basically mean is that our Microsoft SQL Server has rightly installed. Right, so since our server is now installed, it's time to install our SQL Server Management Studio. So for that you need to just simply click on install SSMS, and what it will do is it will going to redirect you to their browser, and see here we have download SQL Server Management Studio. So here if you just simply scroll down you'll be getting this free download SQL Server Management Studio. So just simply click on that, and it will going to start downloading our SSMS, right? So since I have already downloaded it, I just simply cancel it, and if I just simply minimize my browser and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can see this SSMS setup has rightly downloaded over here. And you can see the file size is 653 MB, right? So it's also a big file. Okay, so now that you need to install, you need to just simply double click on it, and it will again ask you for administrative privileges. So for that just simply click on yes, and let us first minimize our download directory. And you can see that our Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio installation wizard has rightly opened. So this is going to be our installation destination. If you want to change, you can always do that by just simply clicking on change button, but I'll be, you know, keeping this as default, and then just simply click on install. And what it will do is it will going to start installing our Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio. So this entire process will take about again 3 to 5 minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back right after finishing up this process. Yeah. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio has rightly installed. So just, you know, simply click on. And now to launch our Microsoft SQL Server, you need to just simply click on the search icon. And here you need to just simply type SSMS. And it is going to show you this Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio 18. So you need to just simply click on that. And it will going to launch our SQL Server Management Studio. And you can see it has rightly launched over here. So server name is rightly set and we are doing just Windows authentication. So keep this all default. So just simply click on connect. And it will, you know, automatically going to connect to our SQL server. Right, and see it is rightly connected. So if we just simply expand our databases, you can see that we have system database, then we have database snapshots. So you can open a system database and here we have these four databases, which is, you know, our default one. So you can always create a new database. So for that you need to just simply click on new query. So here this is basically our SQL query window. So you can, you know, just simply create a new database by just simply typing create database. You can name any database name. So I'm going to give emp details and I'm going to just simply execute this command. And you can see it is, you know, command completed successfully. I'm going to, you know, just maximize it so that you can have a better visibility. So now you can easily create a new table. So for that just simply type create table emp, let's say, and then you need to provide your column name. So let's give the column name as emp id as int, and then last name or just simple name, okay, as a where char. Let's give it as a 50. Right, then you need to just simply end with a semicolon and you need to just simply execute it and it will go into, you know, completed successfully command. So a table has been successfully created. Let's insert some column. So I'll just, you know, simply type insert into emp and then we have emp id comma name, and then we need to give value. Let's give a couple of values. So emp id I'll give 1 and name let's give it as Rohit Sharma, and it will be emp underscore id because that's the column name we have set. So just, you know, simply select and execute it and you can see one row affected. So our data has been successfully inserted. So if you just now simply select star from emp and if you just simply execute it, you can see that our table emp along with the data that you have inserted has successfully shown over here. So in this way you can easily install Microsoft SQL Server on your Windows operating system. So you need to install Microsoft SQL Server and then you need to install this Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio, that is SSMS, to, you know, use this IDE, and you can easily run the command over here. Right, so that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.